Hey guys, in this video, we're going to work through how to use the FV function in Excel. So first thing is we need to remember what the FV function is for. FV stands for future value, and the future value function is used to find any situation where you're dealing with a savings account. So I've got a couple of examples set up for us. So let's start on the left. Richard and Maria received a wedding gift of $5,000 from Richard's parents. They decide to use this money to start saving for a house. They deposit the money in an account that pays 2.4% interest compounded monthly and then make monthly deposits of $200. How much will they have in the account after 4 years? So this is a very basic example using future value because we are asked to find the future value of the money in an account. So these are the things that we have to know to find that. We have to know the APR, which stands for annual percentage rate, and that is our 2.4%. So in this spot, we'll put 0.024. N stands for the number of times it's compounded per year, and we are told this is compounded monthly, so that would be 12. Y stands for the number of years, and in this case, it's happening for 4 years. PMT is short for payment, and we are told they're making a $200 payment. And P stands for the principal, which is the original starting amount, and that is the $5,000 gift that they are starting the account with. Now, once you have all of this information typed in, then you're ready to actually use your FV function. So when you set this up, the bottom will always be where you type in the formula. So it is equals FV, because that's the name in Excel. And then what you want to do is get the first parentheses open. And once you do that, if you come up here near this formula bar, there's an FX button. We call that the function button. If you hit that, it will give you this pop-up window that lets you type in all the things that you need to make the future value function work correctly. So, first thing it asks for is rate, and our rate means the rate per period. So we have to take the whole annual percentage rate and divide it by the number of times it's compounded, which is N. So to find rate, you always take the APR and divide by N. N per means the total number of times it's compounded. So that's going to be 12 times each year for 4 years. So N per is always going to equal the N times the Y. Payment. Now, something about Excel is that when you type in the numbers that are the money, you have to put them in with negatives so that Excel will actually work the formula correctly. So we hit the negative button and then we click on the payment number. And then PV means present value, which is the same as the principal. So we put negative and click on the principal. Now type is something that we always leave blank because the type we want is the default type. So then you can hit OK and it'll work it out for us. Now in this problem, we were solving for the future value. So I will highlight that to show where our answer is. So after 4 years, with the deposits they made, starting with the $5,000, they should have $15,568.62. So this is how we set everything up. Now, what if we have a slightly different question? If Richard and Maria decide they want to have $20,000 saved up after 4 years, how much will they need to deposit in the account each month? Now, in this case, we're assuming the same account, so the APR is still 0.024, N is still 12 for monthly, we're still doing this for 4 years. The payment, though, is what we don't know. How much will they need to deposit in the account each month? So this is the one that I'll highlight because that's what we're actually solving for. The principal is still the original $5,000. And FV is where we put the formula in. So equals FV, open the first parentheses, and then hit that function button up here near the formula bar. Now, this time you get to see why we always want to make sure to use the cell references in this box, because we're going to have to solve for something other than the future value. And the only way we can do that is use GoalSeek. But GoalSeek will only work if we use cell references. So rate is always APR divided by N. N per is always N times Y. Payment is negative of the payment number, even if the cell is blank. Principal is negative of the principal, and we leave type blank. Now, before we do our goal seek, a blank cell is treated as a zero. So with zero payments into this account, it will only have grown up to a future value of $5,500. So what we want to do now is we want that future value to get up to be $20,000. So we use goal seek to find the payment needed to make the formula work out to be $20,000. So remember where data is, or where goal seek is. You have to go to the data tab, over to what if, and then you can choose goal seek. Now, to remind you how goal seek works, your set cell is always your formula cell. To value is the value you want the formula to work out to be, which in this case is $20,000. By changing is the input cell you want to change to make that final value happen. And we want to change the payment. Then you can hit OK. And Excel will work out for us that we need a payment of $288.05 each month to get up to that goal of having $20,000 at the end. So I hope this helps when you're working through your future value problems. The biggest thing to remember is that if you're working with any problem involving savings, you have to use the FV function. And remember when you're filling in the box to only use cell references. Well, thanks for watching, and look for more videos in the future. Thanks. Bye.